this week is all about the LU factorization and how it relates to Gaussian elimination. So for this opener, let's run through an example. Here we have a system of linear equations, and the purpose of the game is to determine the variables that satisfy the system. And you may remember being taught a method called elimination, or Gaussian elimination, in which you take multiples of rows, which you subtract off of other rows, in order to eliminate terms below the diagonal, so that you end up with an upper triangular system, and then that upper triangular system you can solve by first solving for the last variable, plugging that in, solving for the next variable, and so forth. That's known as Beck substitution. Now, rather than actually writing down the full equations every time you do a step of this, you were probably taught to instead write down what's known as an appended system, where you just take all of the coefficients that appear on the left and make them into a matrix, and then take the values that are on the right and plug them in, and then you perform the exact same operations as you would with the equations, but you only push around and compute with the coefficients. So what would you do? Well, for example, to create a zero here, what you would do is say, I want to take a multiple of the first row and subtract it off that row. So notice that if you do -1 times the first row and then subtract it off, that's the same as adding the two rows together, and that would put a zero right here. So -1 times -1 subtracted off of 2 would give you a 1. And -1 times 1 subtracted off of 1 would give you a 2. And then -1 times 1 subtracted off of -1 would give you 0. And then you would move on. Now, I want you to go ahead and complete this whole process just to refresh your memory. But as you're doing it, we really would like to store these multipliers, these values that we use to multiply rows by to subtract off of one, and I want you to store those over the zeros that actually appear, just in case we might need them in the future. For example, if we didn't know what the right-hand side was yet, and later we were given a right-hand side, then with those values you could recreate what it is that you need to do to the right-hand side. All right, so here I would put -1, and just to sort of indicate that that's not really part of the appended system anymore, you may want to put a box around it or something like that to indicate that implicitly underneath there is actually a 0 that's part of the appended system now. So go ahead and go through the motions and actually reduce this appended system to an upper triangular system, and then come back to the next video.